thing to teach by example. And I have many great teachers who I try to follow their examples still to this day. And all of them were great performers and always took, you know, the initiative to perform in public. And so that left a mark on me, and I thought that it's a valuable thing to continue with that. So let's see, next thing I wanted to do is I want to introduce the next performer. This is kind of the adult performer part of the program. The next person is an individual who I met because his son has been my student and is now a student at the University of Tennessee as a trombone major. And as a parent, he was involved, as many of you parents know, he was involved in purchasing some instruments. And he kind of discovered that was, you know, he kind of had a knack for that, and he was able to pick out some really, really nice vintage instruments, some instruments that I'm kind of jealous of, frankly. And so at some point I was like, hey, you know, if you're going to own those instruments, maybe you should learn to play them. And he agreed. And so he's been taking lessons for a little bit over a year. We weren't able to have a recital last year, but this is the first opportunity. And when I mentioned it to him, he jumped at it. He said, absolutely. Absolutely, I want to play in the recital. He said, I'm going to be the oldest fifth grader there. but I really can't stress how much I admire that. To go a little bit farther with that, he has not only a son who played trombone, he has a daughter who played viola, and they had to take part in the recitals. And I mean, he flat out said, I want to know what they went through. I want to experience it. It's fair. It's fair. So, it's without further ado, I'm going to introduce the next performer, Mr. Frank Withers.
Thank you.
Cove. It's written by a trombonist who's now a professor at the University of Arkansas, or one of the universities in Arkansas. And he's originally from Oak Ridge. He attended University of Tennessee. And about a year ago, when we all had just found ourselves sitting at home, twiddling our thumbs, wondering what's going to happen, he got a little bit homesick and decided to write this piece. So this piece, Kate's Cove, is a little bit in the style of Aaron Copland. It has an American sound. We use some musical terms, but it has a lot of open fourths and fifths, a lot of major chords, and it kind of expresses something that we have in our ears. There's sort of an American sound to it. You'll be able to kind of hear that. And it does really, I think, he did a great job writing into the music, Cave's, the actual place. Like, I am sure that you'll hear it. You will be able to imagine the meadow and the clouds, mountains in the background, and blue sky, and maybe one big puffy white cloud. And somehow he was able to write all of that into these notes. And I just thought it was something worth mentioning, that this piece is really only about a year old. This is one of the first performances of it. It's not the first. Among them was given by Mr. Samuel Thomas this past semester at University of Tennessee. And we had Chris Sharp as a guest to comment on that. But anyway, I just wanted to take a moment to introduce the piece. And without further ado, Mr. Carter Brady.
Oh, Thank you.
say thank you to my sweetheart and better half, Dr. Emmy Kagawa, for playing piano for us this evening. Right after that, I'd like to thank Alice Basler for providing some refreshments for us immediately following. So thank you for that. I'm looking forward to it, probably more than anybody else. And third, students. Your parents paid for lessons, bought you instruments, drove you to lessons, picked you up from the lessons, checked on how the lessons were going, all that sort of thing. Students, let's give your parents a hand. This has been a hard year for all of us, but this group in particular, and including myself, we've all experienced personal loss in the past year. And we happen to be so lucky that, you know, we can make pretty good music together, if I may say so myself, and be able to play something to contribute to the memory of